20 cycles ago. Heard this town was nothing but a few shacks.
Now look at it.
Yeah. Sometimes I wish I could go back there. See what it was really like to rough it.
You could always head into the wilderness and start your own town.
I think I'll stay here, thanks.
Well, look who it is. Keeping busy?
There's always something to do.
Well, you won't make a living talking to me, unless you mean to rob me.
Wasn't planning on it.
Well then, have a wonderful day.
Hey, you! You're the one taking shots at the Raiders, right?
That's me.
Bad idea. The Raiders have got eyes all over the Reach.
Took down that watchtower, if that's what you're referring to.
Oh, yeah? Well, let's hope there aren't any consequences for the rest of us.
Oh, it's you! You're the new guy, right? Sorry, I missed that. Say that again?
I didn't say anything.
Oh, right. Must be that ringing in my ears. The other day, this roller mine blew up, nearly took my head off. There's a building just off the path to Dredge Canyon. That's where the roller nearly got me. I bet they're guarding something useful, but I'm not going back there.
Maybe we'll check it out.
Be my guest. And be careful! This ringing in my ears is driving me crazy!
Come take a look. See anything you like? Ooh, that's a nice one. That's one of my favorites.
Thank you. What's that? That's all you can do.
It will take more than that.
scrap anything useful out here?
Tons. As soon as something breaks or the raiders show face, folks abandon their projects.
So Kobo's a gold mine for scrappers like us.
You got that right.
You brought that droid in? Saved her too, huh?
Just helped her get back on her feet.
And he asked for nothing in return.
Well, she did let me hang on to her tuner key.
Ooh, a tuner key? What? You found a real one?
That's right.
Do you think I could maybe...
You can't borrow it, Turgle.
Listen, friend, what's your name?
It's Cal.
Moran. Charm. You seem a decent sort, Cal. Look, maybe you're just the latest fool to get tangled up with the Bedlam Raiders, or maybe you're the real deal. But this place will bleed you dry. Understand? Get out while you can.
Noted. Hold that thought. So how'd you become a music producer?
I was born on Riosa, in the Inner Rim.
I've heard of it. Lots of heavy industry.
Yeah, you couldn't escape the factories. So I used to make little tunes out of the noise from them in my head.
You started early then.
And never stopped.
Hiya.
Listen, friend, what's your name?
It's Cal.
Moran. Charm.
Pardon me.
Not now, Cal. Why don't we catch up once you return?
Ree's always had an eye for eccentric art. How'd you go from making sounds on Riosa to becoming a producer?
Well, I put together a few rough tracks.
Give me a minute. Let's see here. Cue the music. What do I want to hear? All right, let's hear it. Long. We worked together on Coruscant.
And what line of work exactly?
A little of this, a little of that.
I see. Say no more, Cal, say no more. I know when I'm about to step in it. Actually, that reminds me of a colorful expression from Telestar. If you stand beneath the Presta bird nest, rain will come even in the desert.
And when the rain comes...
You best get out of the way. Let's chat later. Z and I are catching up on the state of the galaxy.
You never told me where you're from, Boat.
You're in there. Spent a lot of my life on Beeren. That's where Kata was born. Ever been?
I haven't.
In a rim. Sleepy, but it suited us for a while. Though it didn't. Oh, don't sweat it, BD. You take the good with the bad, right? There were good times on Beeren, too. Gotta remember those. Otherwise, how do you go on, you know?
even if you say the sea spray, what's this mess that here comes?
I guess not.
You're the aspect of a fish or what? And lucky for you, we're perched just above the lair of the sea fish.
Sea fish, huh?
That's right. An impossible catch. No fisher in the right mind would pursue such a quarrelsome foe. No fisher, but Skiver Stev.
Can't go this way.
Where are we? Ah, yes. By virtue of my prodigious fishing talents, I was taken to see the mysterious one they call Undun. I can see it still. We scuba ushered into yon black-mouthed cave. I could barely make out a figure glinting with moonlight. I scrubbed my eyes like a old tar scrubbing the deck. And there she was, a vast creature. Great tentacles blooming from her blubber, like cables gorging on a fuel tank. One of the tentacles twitched into the air, just over my head, and then, wham! Right on the noggin, so I'm told. I staggered out the cave like a lover first acquainted with the deck. But something else happened, I think. When that fell tentacle struck me, Undun took something straight out of my brain and put something else in.
She put something in your brain?
Aye, boy. The subtle art of catching a fish. The art of focus. And in the dark, with nothing but the bristles on your chin for company, that focus is special. From that day forward, when I plunged my line into the frigid waters, it would emerge with a fish. 3 times out of 7.
That's less than half.
My manager told me that I'd be the one to save them from the great fish famine. Little did I know that the grapnel was soon to arrive on our shores.
Gonna assume that's a bad thing.
Perhaps, lad. And perhaps not. But that'd be a story for another time.
I really need a stem. What a view. Better could plant a great garden up here with a little help. All right, let's try planting these seeds we found. Let's plant this here. And you go over here. garden's looking kind of respectable. Got new seeds to plant. We'll grow safe here. Got a solid beginning here. Let's build on it. Got some seeds. Let's get them in the ground. Not bad. I've seen worse rooftop gardens. barely escaped Coruscant, Grease. Wish I had you by my side.
Yeah, me too. There'd be less to repair on the Manning.
You ever have any close calls like that?
Oh, yeah. I was out in the Ryloth system one time. Suddenly, I see three modified light Corvettes on my tail. Oh, yeah, it was bad. We play pirate. I tried every evasive move in the book. Full throttle, I couldn't lose them.
So how'd you escape?
I managed to divert the power from the ship's climate control to its engine. It gave me the extra boost to shake those pirates off, and a new trick to push the Mantis whenever I needed it.
That's why the Mantis always gets colder at full speed.
A greasy secret. Don't you tell nobody.
Maybe a little punch of hydrogen to save this tragedy of a drink.